So, once again, let's go. Gosh, this is weird looking at myself when it's not myself. That's too funny. Hello, hello, friends! So, you want to be a VTuber? That's great! I'm so excited for you! But where do you even start? Well, I'm going to show you what it's like to start with nothing and work your way through all of the technical aspects to be ready to stream and make YouTube videos. And we're going to do it on a budget of $0. So let's get started, shall we? Okay, first things first, a little disclaimer. This is just how I did it. There are many ways to get started as a VTuber, but hopefully this way will be simple and affordable. Now, at this point, you've probably already thought up an idea for your avatar and maybe even have art for them. Well, the first step after that is to actually make your model. Now, there are a few ways to do this, but I'm going to go over the simplest way that'll get you streaming fast. We're going to go over a free program called Vroid Studio. This is a great program because you can completely customize your model and the rigging is already done. So, if you're on a budget, you can make your own model without having to pay someone to make it and rig it for you. So, how do we get Vroid Studio? Well, let's search for it. In Google, let's search for Vroid Studio. And there it is. First thing that comes up is Vroid.com. And here you go. Right on the front page, you can download it. Let's click download. And we want to either install on Steam, or I'm on a Windows, so I'm going to install it for Windows. And it'll pop up right here as it downloads. When it opens, it'll ask you where you want it to be installed, and usually gives you exactly the folder that it wants to be put in. So you should just be able to hit next. I don't want a desktop shortcut, so I'm going to unclick that. Hit next, and it'll install. Okay, now that it's installed, let's go ahead and open it up. I put mine in my VTubing folder. It should look something like this. When you open it, you'll see all of these different assets, but the only one you need to worry about is this application. Let's go ahead and open it. And what you'll probably see is all of these sample avatars and nothing under your avatars. And that's okay, we're going to make one. So click on New Avatar, and we'll get started. Okay, let's choose this avatar. Great, when it opens, it'll look something like this. Now you can click on your avatar with the wheel of your mouse, hold it down, and you can drag them up. Then you can scroll in so we have a better look at what we're doing. So let's get to customizing, shall we? Let's scroll in and look at the eyes. That's the first thing I want to change. I'm going to go to Texture, and I'm going to click on Irises, and let's play with the color here. Make sure you click on Layer, click your brush tool, make sure your opacity is all the way up and your composition is normal. Now we can draw on the eyes. Now, you can get as detailed as you want with this, but I'm going to keep it pretty simple for the sake of this video. Okay, super simple, just so we can keep moving. Next, let's look at the hair. Click on your Hair tab. Now, I'm not really going to go into how to do hair exactly, just because there are so many YouTube tutorials already that explain how to do hair so well, and I'm really not the best at it, so I'm not the right person to teach you. Okay, it's not perfect, it's a little bit of a rush job, but we have hair. Now, let's just give it some bones. Okay, so we have a super, 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 super simple model. Now, let's just do one more thing before we export her. Let's go to our Clothing Editor tab, and let's put her in a one-piece dress. And the reason for that is because I want to give her a new dress. And again, we can do this for $0. And to give her a new dress, we're just going to go to booth.pm. Now, I've already made a video about giving your avatar new clothing via booth.pm, and you can find it up here or in the link down below. We're going to use booth.pm to search for Vroid, And you'll see a lot of different options for clothing come up, and a lot of them are free. So let's find a free dress to put on our avatar. Ooh, I really like this one. I think it'll go great with our avatar. Let's go ahead and get it. You'll see here that it says free download. It's 0 Japanese yen. So we can just click on this, and it downloads right at the bottom here as a zip. Let's open up the zip file location, and let's right click and say extract here. And voila, here we are, we have the dress. So let's go back to our VRoid studio, and under the clothing editor, one piece outfit, we're gonna hit our texture tab. Under texture, we're gonna go to the default image. You're gonna right click and say import, and we're gonna find that dress, which looks like just a regular picture. But when you pull it in, there we go! Ah, she looks so pretty! So, here we are with our new avatar. You made her from scratch. We did the eyes, the hair, the dress. So that was a very basic look at how to make an avatar in VRoid Studio. And I made it simple just so that we can move on and get you streaming fast. So now that you have an avatar ready to go, the next thing to do is to export her. So what you want to do is go to the camera exporter tab. Over here, you're going to want to choose export on the left here. You'll see that she comes into this T-pose position and she's ready to be exported. Over here on the right hand, all you have to do is click export, give her a name. Let's name her Sarah. She looks like a Sarah to me. Hit okay. And once again, let's name her Sarah. And you're saving it out as a VRM. This is what you'll need to stream. Give it a second to process. And voila, you've now exported your avatar. Don't forget to save your avatar because exporting and saving is very different. Exporting means that you're exporting your avatar for other uses, but you want to save your progress. Go to save as, we'll call this Sarah. That way, if you need to edit her more or give her a new outfit, you can open her back up. Okay, so now you have your model all exported and ready to go. But what's next? Well, it's time to get your avatar capturing software. Today, I'm gonna show you the free program called VCFace because that is what I use. Okay, so we're back at Google once again. Let's do a search for VCFace. And the first thing that comes up is vcface.icu. This is where you're going to want to go to download VCFace. When you click it, you'll see this page right here. You can scroll down and click download. It'll have the most recent version for you already ready to go. Let's click it. And you can see it's downloading right here for you. Now that it's downloaded, let's right click and say show in folder. You're going to want to right click it and say extract here. Once you've done that, you'll see a folder that says VCFace. Open it up, and once again, you'll see a whole bunch of assets, but the only one you need to worry about is VCFace. So when you open it up, what you'll see is probably a blank box here with a big plus sign to add your avatar. Let's click that button. Find your VRM wherever you saved your character. For me, it was Sarah. I'm going to click on that and say open. And voila, there she is. I'm gonna click on her, and you'll see over here on the right that she pops up. Next, you wanna make sure that you're using the right camera. Make sure that you have your webcam ready to go, and that you have your microphone ready to go. Next, you're gonna wanna hit start, and voila, here you are with your new avatar. Next, we want to take a couple minutes to make sure that all of our settings are right. So you want to go up here to settings, and let's start with our general settings. This is where you can do all of your customization for the movement of your avatar. You can change stuff like lip syncing, mouth sensitivity, and body stiffness, as well as many other things. So the best thing I can say to do is to take a couple of minutes to play with these settings and make sure that your avatar is moving exactly how you want them to. Then, once you're done playing with your settings, come down to this little button right here on the right. Click it, and your menu bars will disappear. Then, to get rid of this little button, just hit the space bar, and voila, everything is gone except for your avatar. If you need to get everything back, just hit the space bar again, and click the button, and voila, you're back. Okay, so it's finally time for the last step. This is the hardest step to get set up, but don't worry, we'll make it through. Now is time to download Streamlabs OBS. Once again, it's another free program. Isn't this great? We're doing so much for free. I'm so excited. So, once again, let's go. Gosh, this is weird looking at myself when it's not myself. Like I was saying, once again, let's go to our old friend Google. And let's search for Streamlabs OBS. And the first thing that comes up is streamlabs.com. That's exactly what we want. So let's go ahead and click it. This is what comes up when you open up the page. And right here, without even scrolling, is the download button. So let's click it. And once again, it downloads in our left-hand corner down here. Once it's ready, let's open up folder location. And voila, the application is right here and ready to go. All you need to do is double click it and click I agree. Next, you need to choose an install location and it should give you a default folder that works great. Ready? Install. Once it's installed, you can open it and you'll first be prompted to connect whichever streaming platform you're going to be using. Just click on which one you want and sign in. OBS will connect with your profile. Next, it'll ask if you're importing from OBS or starting fresh. Because we just downloaded it and this is your first time, you'll just want to click Start Fresh. Next, it'll ask you to set up your mic and webcam. This is pretty self-explanatory. Basically, just choose your webcam and your mic. The next step is that OBS will want to help you optimize. If you choose to do this, Streamlabs will analyze your internet speed and computer hardware to make sure that you're getting the best possible settings. I do suggest doing this if you're not very tech savvy. And finally, it'll ask if you want to enable multi-stream, but honestly, that's something you don't really need to worry about at this point. I'd skip it. Okay, so when you open up Streamlabs OBS, it's going to look something like this. The only thing that'll be different is that down here you won't have as much as I have. Because I use OBS, I already have a ton of scenes here, but don't worry about those. The first thing we want to do is start a new scene. So to do that, we just click this button, say add new scene. It'll ask you what you want to name it. Let's call this YouTube screen. Okay, now that we have our YouTube screen up, now we can play with our sources down here. The first thing we want to add is our avatar. So what you want to do is go up to this plus button and choose game capture. Trust me, it'll make sense in a second. Add the source, and we're going to choose add a new source. Let's call it VC Face Capture. Add source. And look at that, it's already detected that our VC face is open and is choosing to record it. If it doesn't show up automatically, you can go to mode and choose capture a specific window, and then you'll see the windows pop up and you can choose from these VC face. Now you want to make sure that you click allow transparency. When you click that, bam, everything goes away. You might not want to capture the cursor. Turn that off and you're done. So now we can resize this however we want. Let's go ahead and make it big. Now you can still see the menu bar, but remember we learned how to get rid of that by going back to VC Face, clicking on this little button and clicking spacebar. Now we can go back to our Streamlabs and voila, all you can see is your avatar. Next, what we need to do is we need to add a microphone. So let's go ahead and add audio input capture. Add source, and you're gonna wanna create a new source. We'll call this microphone capture. Add the source. Under device, you should be able to find your microphone. Then that's it. You'll hit done, and you'll see here that the microphone is now popping up down here, and you can see live that it's capturing. Okay, so we have our microphone, and we have our VC face. What's next? Well, let's put in a background, shall we? Let's go back to our old friend Google one more time. And let's look for royalty-free backgrounds. I like to use Unsplash. It has amazing options and they're completely free. Why don't we look for something that's pink? Ooh, I like this one with the cloud. Let's go ahead and download it for free. Now, let's go ahead and add an image. Add source. And let's hit add a new source. We'll call this pink clouds. Okay. Now we're gonna browse for it and we're gonna hit done. Now we can resize it. There we go. Now, you might be wondering why we can't see our avatar. Well, that's because the pink clouds, right here, is above our VC face capture. It's always going to show the layers from top to bottom. So all we have to do is drag. And there we go. Our VC face avatar is now on top of the image. So now you have a start for your YouTube videos. You can also have a video background by using Media Source. Okay, now let's say you want to make a YouTube video of yourself drawing, or maybe a tutorial video, and you want your avatar to be in the corner, and you want to capture your screen so that you can share with everybody what you're doing. Well, easy peasy. Let's first resize our avatar to go in the corner. And then next, let's go back to our sources. We're going to hit Display Capture. Add this source, and you can add a new source, and there you go. It should automatically display your monitor. Now you can click whether or not to capture your cursor. I like to capture my cursor because I'm doing tutorials. It's easy for people to follow along if they can see my cursor. Okay, so now you have your display capture. But once again, our avatar has gone away. So we need to move the avatar up. And voila, you're ready to make YouTube videos. All you have to do is hit the record button. Okay, with YouTube videos out of the way, what about streaming? Let's set up a new scene and get you ready to stream. So I'm gonna come over here and add a new scene. Click. Once again, we're facing a black screen, fresh canvas. All right, first thing we wanna do is put in our game capture again. And let's go ahead and choose our VC face capture. As you can see, OBS actually remembers all of the things you bring in, so you don't have to bring them in every single time. Hit Add Source. Next, let's remember to add a microphone, very important. Go to Audio Input Capture, and it's going to remember your microphone. So let's go ahead and add that source. And once again, this scene now has a microphone capture. Next, let's get ready to set up a game. Let's open up my Steam. Let's pull up Stardew Valley, shall we? Let's hit play. Okay, so now we have a game loaded, ready to go. And what you'll want to do is add another game capture. Let's add a new source and we'll call this Stardew Valley. Add the source. And it says here, looking for a game to capture. All you have to do is go to mode, capture a specific window, and we want to do Stardew Valley. There it is, it pops right up. Here are your settings if you want to change anything. If not, just hit done. Now we can pull this and make it big. But once again, we need to bring our VC face up to the top. Oh, and remember, if you're trying to capture the audio of your game, make sure that you pull up your speakers here. We're not going to go over overlays today because all I wanted to do was get you streaming. You can look at overlays a little bit later. This is the bare bones of getting you ready to stream. Next, all you have to do is go to the corner here and say, go live. Then this will pop up and it'll say stream to Twitch. As you remember, we linked our account when we first opened OBS. Then you'll want to change your title to whatever you want. Change your game to Stardew Valley. And then you can add some tags if you would like. Next, you want to use Optimize Encoder settings for Stardew Valley, that works. And then you can say confirm and go live. Then you're streaming, way to go. Okay, so there you go. From nothing to streaming in one quick video. We didn't cover a lot of details or specifics. This was just the basics. As you grow and develop your skills, you can do things like alter your avatar and Vroid more, play in Photoshop, get overlays, and so much more to make your stream or video top notch. Thank you so much for watching this video. I hope it was helpful to you. Let me know if you have any questions in the comments down below, and consider subscribing for more tutorials. Okay, bye for now.